I will repair this Fujitsu Mini Split Air Conditioner Indoor Circuit Board in this video. When I am powering this motherboard with electricity, it is not turning on at all. A fuse is installed over here in this circuit. First, I will check whether this fuse is good or bad. I have set the multimeter to continuity mode. I am placing the multimeter probes on the fuse to check it. The fuse is showing continuity means it is fine. A hidden fuse is also installed in this Fujitsu motherboard. I think most of the people would not know about it. Let me show you. It is installed inside the terminal connectors. I will open the screw to show you that hidden fuse. I have removed the terminal out. I will now push the plastic upward. You can see this light blue wire. This is that hidden fuse attached to the neutral wire of the terminal. Let me show you its capacity. This is a 250 volts and a 3 ampere fuse. It can bear a temperature of 102 degrees. I have attached the red probe with the blue and white wire. The black with probes with the blue wire of the terminal. I am checking the continuity of the fuse. The multimeter is showing a continuity reading, which means this fuse is also fine. I will test it further, so I have passed electricity through it. No light is glowing on its display. Let's check whether electricity is flowing in this circuit or not. This component is attached after this fuse. This is a ZNR. Voltages are flowing through the ZNR. Checking the ZNR will confirm whether electricity is entering this circuit or not. I have set the multimeter on AC voltages. I have attached the probes of the multimeter, and 234 volts are flowing through this ZNR. This means the electricity is flowing inside this circuit. I took a look at the physical condition of this PCB. It seems to be new. Nothing seems to be damaged in this motherboard. Electricity is already flowing through it. I will check the voltages on the different sections of this circuit. Let's check the bridge rectifier first. These are the AC pins of this bridge rectifier. And these are the DC pins. So let's check how many volts are flowing through its DC pins. 314 volts are flowing on the DC pins. This means this capacitor would also have the same voltages. Absolutely, the voltages are the same. Next, I will test this IC. The number of the IC is TNY274PN. I will check this IC with the oscilloscope. We could not check the voltages directly on the drain pin of this switching IC. A special kind of waveform is formed on it, which will be tested through the oscilloscope. Other than this, if the feedback is not generated to the IC still, it will not power on. The feedback is passed through pin number 1, which senses that further voltages are passed through this IC or not. At pin number 2 of this IC, current limit is made. You can see this small ceramic capacitor over here. This capacitor decides what will be the current limit for the IC. The current limit depends on the value of the capacitor. I have soldered a wire to the capacitor positive pin, which is attached to the oscilloscope. I will check the waveform on the switching IC pin number 4, which is the drain pin. This IC has a MOSFET inside. The 5, 6, 7 and 8 are the source pins. The MOSFET is NPN. I have placed the probe on pin number 4. This is the waveform which we can see through the oscilloscope. The waveform is generated on this pin, which means this switching IC is working. 92 volts are passed through this pin. In case this waveform was not generated, then it would have been clear that the switching IC is not working. Next, on capacitors number 9 and 10, I will check the voltages. First, let's check the voltages on the capacitor number 9. 5 volts are passing through this capacitor. It is fine. Now on the capacitor number 10. And 15 volts are passed through this capacitor. This means the chopper in this circuit is functioning okay. Now next, I will check this microcontroller. I will check the voltages on pin number 24 of the microcontroller, which has capacitor number 19 attached to it. 5 volts are flowing through the capacitor. This means the microcontroller is functional. Next, I will check the pin numbers 47 and 48. With these pins, capacitor number 24 is attached. 5 volts are flowing through this circuit cap 2. I will now check the 40 number pin of the microcontroller. This is the 40 number pin. I have placed one probe with pin number 40 of the microcontroller. The other with the ground on the capacitor. 5 volts are passing here as well. The voltages that turn on the microcontroller are all fine. Resistor number 49 has a resistance of 0. And if this goes bad, the reset voltages will not pass and the microcontroller program will crash. Let me tell you what really happened to this circuit board. The customer told me that his office had an electricity surge. Due to that electric surge, many equipment in his home got bad. This Fujitsu Mini Split Air conditioner circuit also stopped working. That is why he sent me. I talked to him on the phone and told him to press the emergency switch and try to set it through the remote to confirm that it is actually problematic. But as I switched its emergency switch on the display while troubleshooting the fault, the circuit board turned on. You can see 2 lights are now blinking on its display. Sensors are not installed in it, that is why it is showing this error. I have attached the blower motor with it. And let's check whether it turns on with the remote or not. It has started to work with the remote as well. The blower motor has also started to work. Now I am waiting for its output. This switching relay will turn on, then it will pass electricity on the output terminal. And if it does not turn on, the electricity will not flow to the outdoor. The relay has switched on. So, what was the issue with this motherboard? This motherboard has been fixed without changing any component in it. Sometimes some components in the motherboard get stuck or get hung after the electricity surge. And when we pass electricity through it after some time or days, it starts working again. So, this might have happened with this motherboard. After 2 days of shooting this part of the video, I went to the customer's office. I fit the motherboard. And the motherboard didn't make any problem. I couldn't shoot a video in the customer's office. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.